It's great.
He's singing for us as well.
Your own solo album.
Mm-hmm.
Why now? Why do you think now is a good time to bring them all out again?
Well, it's been 10 years since the previous Greatest Hits. Aye, 10 years. Oh, and I thought it'd be a nice idea to re-record some of the back catalogue, you know, and just kind of...
And put a different spin on it, maybe?
Aye, a different spin. You know, I did a couple of tours with them and I kind of changed them a little bit. And, you know, I mean, they weren't broke, so they didn't need fixing, but it was just put a little bit of where I'm at just now and how I feel about the songs.
Yeah. Do you feel, you know, now that you've been in Chicago and that was a triumph?
Chicago.
You loved that because I saw the first night. You really looked comfy. You looked at home. Look at that cheeky smile. But you did look very relaxed. There's a lot of people on stage who they don't make the transition from doing music to stage. Mm-hmm. I mean, it makes sense for bums on seats because people will come see.
Absolutely.
But you looked really comfy there.
It was great. That was a great experience for me because I'd never done anything like that before. Mm-hmm. And with the right help, it just, well, you know, I managed to pull it off. I mean, the good thing about this show is whether or not I was in it or not, it would be a packed house because it is such it's so well written and with a fussy choreography and a great cast, you know, just can pull it off. It's such a brilliant show.
But I always remember even when you were with Wet Wet Wet, there was always talk about you doing musicals. It was always, you know, you're going to be starring in just about every West End musical part.
When I had the long hair, the Jesus Christ Superstar
That's
thing.
That's right, everybody said they were. Yeah. So was it always something that made sense for you to do or something?
It was at this time in my life at the moment. That was, it all made sense to go back into to go into that environment, but I really did enjoy it. I never thought I'd become as passionate about something else apart from songwriting. And for me, it was just a great pleasure to do it. I remember trying to work on my accent, you know, the American accent, and I remember I met a couple of guys from Chicago, and I said, okay, I'll try this American accent on them. So I spoke to them for a little while and the guy turned around and said to me, so which part of Wales are you from?
Okay, so didn't quite work.
I said, I better...
That needs a bit of work, perhaps.
I need to fine-tune that one.
Yes, maybe so.
Right.
Now, Chicago, is that you finished or are you going to be doing some more touring with that?
No, I'm going to do some touring dates with that. I think I'm going to Manchester. I'm going to spend a little bit of time in Dublin with it as well. You know, because I really did enjoy it and I have the luxury of having a bit of time that I can put aside for it and continue to do it and take it into the regions, you know.
Right.
They can come and see me, you know.
Excellent. Yep. Now, you're fine, you're fitting well, you've put all that behind you, you're looking good. You're awful skinny though, you've got awful thin, Marti.
Well,
what's happened?
You know,
is that the working? Because that happened to Denise Van Outen when she did Chicago.
Well, I'll tell you what.
She lost her boobies.
My breasts are filming down as well, I know.
But it's just hard work.
It was just hard work. It was the 8 shows a week, and I've started. I tried this Pilates.
Oh yes. Uh-huh.
Which I thought was a Greek starter. I wasn't too sure where we were coming from, but I was just saying to a couple of guys earlier on there, it works. You know. So and I feel a little bit taut and this gazelle-like physique, so I can just get.
Gazelle-like physique is very, very good.
For working, treading the boards.
No, absolutely. So you're going to sing a big favourite for us now. What are you going to do?
Well, you asked me to sing Love Is All Around from Four Weddings and a Funeral, which I would be delighted to do for you.
That was number one for about 3 years, wasn't it?
I think it still is. that was a phenomenal song for Wet 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 and myself.
It sums up a whole kind of era, I suppose, as well. So the album is out right now?
The album's out right now, it's went gold already.
It's got all the crackers in it. It's got Love Is All Around, Wishing I Was Lucky, Angel Eyes. I love Wishing I Was Lucky, that's one of my favourites. Fantastic. Right now, if you toddle over there...
I will do.
In our high-tech studio, and you do the song for us, that'd be great. It's like my own wee private concert. It's great
to
see you, Marti.
And well done to the husbands. I thought they were great.
Weren't they good?
Nice. Fantastic.
And hunky.
Oh, yes.
Very, very hunky.
Very much so.
So here is Marti Pellow. It was 1994. It can't have been that long ago, was it? And it's Love Is All Around. Here he is, live in the studio.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. My baby, bye, bye, bye. Feel it in my fingers, I feel it in my toes. Love's all around me, and so the feeling grows. It's written on the wind, it's everywhere I go. It is. So if you really love me, come on and let it show. Come on and let it show now. Yeah. You know I love you, I always.
Better now even than you did then, and I can't believe you're singing live at this time in the morning.
Oh, well, neither can I.
What a voice. Thank you, Marti.
Too kind.
Thank you very much. Now, if you